Module-based planning provides complete planning and budgeting solutions for financials, workforce, capital, projects, and strategic modeling with built-in, best practice, predefined content, including forms, calculations, dashboards, drivers, and key performance indicators. Capital enables the planning for the long-term impact of capital asset investments on financial plans. Enabled capital tasks include investments, existing assets, intangibles, and analysis. Let's start with new investments. Each task opens to an overview dashboard. The Investments Overview dashboard displays a quick summary and comparison of capital expenses and how they impact your financial statements. The capital planning task icons are displayed on top. Expand the content area using the Show Hide button. You can monitor assets associated with a project and the expenses incurred until its completion on the Capital Work in Progress dashboard. Before we start adding assets, let's go over assumptions. Assumptions are used to calculate depreciation, amortization, insurance, and other expenses. For each asset class, enter the useful life in years, the depreciation methods, and convention. You can plan for existing asset expenses and decide whether to lease or buy investments. You set the following funding assumptions per asset class: cash flow incidence, funding options for asset requests, cash flow and funding staggered values for staggered calculations. Enter assumptions for other expenses such as taxes, repairs, insurance, and maintenance expenses on this page. Now that we have assumptions defined, we can start planning for new assets. The right-click actions menu allows you to perform tasks, like adding a new asset. You enter new asset detail plan for an asset class and project. For assets that do not belong to a project, select No Project. You can take a look at your assets at a per-project level on the New Assets from Projects page. With the right-click actions menu, you can run calculations for depreciation and amortization. On this page, you can manage cash flow and funding assumptions for specific assets if their assumptions are different from their asset class. Asset expenses are typically taken from the assumptions you entered, but if your expense drivers are different for specific assets, you can modify them here. For assets added for projects, monitor plan project expenses for the capital work in progress on this page. You can enter asset justification notes on this page. Next, leased assets. New leased assets are managed per asset class and project combination, similar to new capital investments. The right-click actions menu allows you to perform tasks such as adding or removing an asset, calculating lease expenses, and converting the new asset to an existing asset. Let's move on to existing assets. The Asset Overview dashboard is displayed. Just like capital investments, you manage assumptions for existing assets. Here you have your assumptions for depreciation, amortization, funding, and other expenses. On the Manage Assets tab, you can monitor transfers and retirements of existing assets. Use the right-click actions menu to perform asset management tasks such as retirements, transfers, and improvements. Funding and asset-related expense drivers are entered on these two pages. Information captured here is often used to plan asset-related expenses for high-value existing assets. Track asset improvements on this page. Existing leased assets are managed on this page. Now, if your company owns or plans to own intangible assets, such as leasehold improvements, software rights, or goodwill, you can manage them using capital as well. I'll quickly add an intangible asset. Use the right-click actions menu to perform tasks, including calculations. In the same way you manage new and existing assets, you can add new intangible assets, manage existing intangible assets, and enter driver-related information on their corresponding tabs. With analysis, you can review the impact of your capital asset purchases and expenses in total on the income statement, balance sheet, and cash flow statement. A quick summary is displayed on the dashboard. Just remember to run calculations before reviewing your reports and financial statements. Review your balance sheet, cash flow impacts, and profit and loss impacts on the Financial Statements tab. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.